Okay, as I told you guys before, this quarantine be getting to these boxers' head. Let me read something from Mr. Gary Russell Jr. It says, Vasily Lomachenko, Teofimo Lopez is one of the fights Gary Russell Jr. is most interested in watching when the boxing business gets back to normal. If Lopez beats Lomachenko, however, the long-reigning WBC featherweight champion won't consider Lopez the best boxer in the sport pound for pound. I don't think Lomachenko should be pound for pound, Russell told AB Boxing News during the interview posted to his YouTube channel Saturday. If I don't think Lomachenko should be pound for pound, it doesn't matter if he beats Lomachenko or not. He shouldn't be pound for pound, neither. Lomachenko shouldn't be pound for pound. I don't think he's a pound for pound fighter. Russell doesn't believe Lomachenko is better than him either. Even though Lomachenko defeated Russell in their 12th round, 126-pound title fight in June 2014, the 31-year-old Russell feels dehydration cost him the fight for the vacant WBO featherweight title at the StubHub Center in Carson, California. Vasily Lomachenko knows he's got a gift, Russell said. He don't have the hand speed that I have. You know, I have the boxing ability, the ring generalship, and the IQ that I got. He got a little seasoning, but overall, he really can't fuck with me. He got a gift. He fought a dehydrated version, the lowest possible version of Mr. Gary Russell Jr. Okay. Now, interesting. Well, one thing about Mr. Gary Russell Jr., if you really felt that way, and if you really felt that Vasily Lomachenko beat you, I would be hearing you hollering like the wolf hollers to the moon about a rematch. After Vasily Lomachenko issued Gary Russell Jr. that beating, Gary Russell Jr. didn't say anything what he is talking about right now, nor did I hear him trying to pursue a fight or trying to get that win back. You can always tell what bothers a fighter by how they react to it. If the fight was really something, and if the fight was really a fight that he thought that he was cheated on, you would have always heard that from Jump Street, and you would have never heard anything different. It just so happens that all this time passed and Gary Russell Jr. is just now talking about fighting a Vasily Lomachenko. Now, one of the reasons why he's trying to downplay Lomachenko, because he's well aware that Teofimo Lopez can get in there and spark Lomachenko straight out. Gary Russell Jr. doesn't want that hanging over his head. He doesn't want people to think that he wasn't capable of doing the job. Now, when it comes to him saying he fought a lower version of Gary Russell Jr., yes, Vasily Lomachenko did fight a lower version of Gary Russell Jr., but you signed the contract. If you feel that you wasn't ready, if you feel that it was a feat that you could not clear, you should not have signed the contract, because in the end, nobody wants to hear excuses, okay? This is what people tell Manny Pacquiao about his shoulder injury. This is what people tell Deontay Wilder about his so-called costume malfunction. Nobody wants to hear it. This is why you have to respect fighters when they say they want enough time to get ready, okay? So therefore, when the fight happens, they don't have an excuse to lean on. I would rather you fight somebody when you're ready than to later on take an ass whooping and say, I had this problem. Because people will tell you, you shouldn't have went into the fight. And not only that, it's also, I can't think of it right now, but what do they call it when they try to sell you something and it's not actually what it is? It's false advertising, okay? Because these people are on the assumption that you are a healthy fighter. Because had they known you was injured or had these problems going into the fight, they probably would have placed their bets a little bit differently on the outcome. That's why you don't do nothing like that. But yes, Vasily Lomachenko fought Gary Russell Jr. coming off a hella layoff. But you want to know something? Gary Russell Jr. has always had hella layoffs. Never been as active as he has supposed to have been. This is one of the problems over there. And this is why they don't want to give him a fight. Okay? Because He doesn't want to be active. He hasn't been active enough. And Gary Russell Jr. is just a great talent, but he does not fight enough. Now, another thing that I want people to notice and to take note of, this is what could happen to a Terrence Bud Crawford in the 147-pound division. Talent just being wasted because he can't get fights. After a while, we don't want to hear that you can't get fights due to this, 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 that, and the third. You're going to have to take initiative to get your own fights. But at this point, Gary Russell Jr. saying that Vasily Lomachenko got a gift against him just sounds like sour grapes. Very disappointing in Mr. Gary Russell Jr. because had his actions matched how he runs his mouth, Gary Russell Jr. would have no problems. Yes, Gary Russell Jr. is a great fighter. Yes, Gary Russell Jr. has excellent hand speed. Yes, Gary Russell Jr. has great ring generalship and ring IQ. It was just absent on the night that you fought Vasily Lomachenko. And if you needed more time, you should have taken more time, okay? But don't wait till one of these young guns come up and fin to do something that you're not going to do. And now you're ready to discredit the win of Teofimo Lopez and the win of Vasily Lomachenko just because you have not lived up to your potential and people are making moves that you are not making, okay? I would say you campaign and try to get a fight, any fight that you can, but the fact that Gary Russell Jr. has always had long layoffs, even as somebody who's in the boxing game, your activity turns me off, okay? So I just thought that was something interesting. Once again, these fighters in quarantine seem to talk a lot of jazz, but Gary Russell Jr. saying that Vasily Lomachenko got a gift. Come on, Gary. You know better than that. Bruce Thane, I'm out.